Calculators, computers, and teachers throughout your life have told you that you can't divide by zero. But I'm here to tell you that you can. It's true. In the real numbers, division by zero isn't defined. But neither is taking the square root of negative one. And yet, mathematicians found a way to do it. Checking all the details might be a bit complex, but ultimately the idea is just throw in a number whose square is negative one, then follow the normal rules of algebra to figure out what this new number system looks like. If you do this with the square root of negative 1, you end up with the familiar complex numbers. They might have some weird properties compared to the reals, but they're a perfectly good system of numbers to work with. Can't we just do the same thing with division by 0? Can't we just throw in an inverse of 0 and see what happens? Given that you've been told your whole life that you can't divide by 0, you might expect that for reasons you don't fully understand, you can't just throw in an inverse of a number the same way you can throw in a solution to x squared equals negative 1. Nope. That's not the problem. The process of throwing in the inverse of a number or set of numbers and seeing what happens is called localization, and it's no more difficult to do than throwing in the square root of negative 1. Suppose you started with the integers. There's no 1 half in the integers, so let's throw it in. In order to be able to multiply numbers as usual, we would also need to throw in all the multiples of 1 half, including negative 1s. And multiplying 1 half with itself means we also need 1 fourth and all the multiples of a fourth, and so on and so forth. We need to add in anything that's an integer divided by a power of 2. But then we're good to go. We end up with what are called the dyadic or binary rationals, which is another weird but perfectly valid number system. If we also threw in a third, a fourth, a fifth, a sixth, inverses of every positive whole number, then we end up with all the rational numbers, ratios of integers where the denominator is not zero. This is a pretty standard way to construct the rationals. So what about zero inverse? Well, let's do it. Let's start with the real numbers, throw in an inverse of zero, and just see what kind of number system pops out. Just like a half is the unique number such that 2 times a half is 1, our inverse of zero is going to be the unique number such that 0 times the inverse of zero is 1. So let's assume that's true. Then what? Pretty quickly, we see this implies that 1 equals 0, because anything times 0 is 0. But wait, this is not a contradiction. Of course, in the real numbers, 0 is different than 1. But in the real numbers, x squared can never be negative either, and yet we're perfectly okay in the complex numbers saying that y squared is negative 1. Just because we've discovered an unintuitive property of this new number system, that doesn't make it wrong. Let's just continue and see where it takes us. Take any number x in this system and note that x is 1 times x, because 1 times anything is that thing. But because 1 equals 0, this is also 0 times x, which of course is 0, because 0 times anything is 0. Thus, we've shown in our new number system that every number equals 0. There's still no contradiction, no error in logic. We've just invented what's called the zero ring, where 0 is the only number. 0 plus 0 equals 0, 0 minus 0 equals 0, 0 times 0 equals 0, 0 divided by 0 equals 0, and 1 is just another label for 0. Feel free to check that this number system satisfies all the normal rules of algebra. It really does. So it's not that you can't divide by 0, it's just that if you allow it, then all numbers are 0 and you get what you deserve.